What's up? How's it going? Welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be going over how to shadowbox proactively, meaning how to get the most out of your shadowbox. Now, before we get into the shadowboxing itself, let's get this out of the way right away. So the first thing you want to do is actually know what you want to get out of shadowboxing, right? Because there are many different variations of shadowboxing and what you can do with it. For example, maybe you want to work on your technique, maybe you want to work on your speed, maybe you want to work on your power, balance, endurance, right? Or maybe you just want to freestyle, right? But freestyling is not very proactive. Like, yes, it's very helpful, but this video is more about a targeted type of shadow boxing, right? Something that you want to get something specific out of your session. So this video is going to be for complete beginners in the beginning, and then the second part of the video is going to be for people who have more than 6 months of experience, let's say, right? So a little bit more experience than just a complete beginner. Now, if you're a complete beginner, it's very important to do your shadow boxing the right way. So what you will want to work on is your balance and your technique, because it's a lot easier to actually build a proper habit than to break a bad one in the future. And I understand it can be very frustrating because you have to keep consciously thinking about what to do next, right? Keep your hands up, exhale on the punches, step this way, don't cross your feet, right? All those little things, it's very unnatural for humans to box, so it makes sense, right? But over time, I promise you, it's going to get a lot easier because it's all about muscle memory, right? That's why boxes, it's all about fundamentals. We repeat the same moves over and over and over again, so it becomes a muscle memory, right? Now, so if you're a complete beginner and let's say you want to work on your balance, and by complete beginner, I mean anywhere from day one to 6 months, right? So first of all, you want to work on your footwork. Keeping your hands up is very easy when you're not doing anything but just focused on your footwork, right? So maybe just take one step forward and back and to the left. Maybe, you know, take a closer angle and then a step back, right? Open side angle and step back. Try those little combinations. Keep just get comfortable in your stance, because boxing is not just throwing punches. Boxing is your footwork. The better your footwork is, the better your boxing is going to get, because you're going to be a lot more balanced. And if you're a lot more balanced, your punches will be a lot more powerful, faster, and clean, right? Even slipping and ducking and rolling, it all comes from your legs, right? Now, if you want to get the most out of your session as a more advanced boxer, so anything past 6 months, many variations. If you want to work on your speed, when you shadow box, you know, relax your shoulders, relax your hands, and just focus on the speed itself, right? And what I like to do when I work for speed is, so just shadow box, you know, with the speed. You're not trying to have powerful punches, you're just trying to increase your speed, right? And at the end of the, let's say, round, for the last minute or 30 seconds, what I want you to do is just throw your punches as fast as possible, right? And then over time, it's going to train your fast twitch muscle. That's where your speed comes from, right? From your fast twitch muscle. If you want to work on your balance, endurance, and power, I want you to shadow box as if you were fighting. Now, start off very slowly so that you're warmed up and you have proper technique, because as I said earlier, you don't want to be building bad habits now. So, but once you're warmed up, make a three minute round, at least start up that way. And I want you to pretend that you're actually fighting, right? So throw powerful punches with your legs, head movement, boom, 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 right? Now, if you wanna just work on the technique as a more advanced boxer, I want you to pretend that like there's somebody is right in front of you, right? And the thing is, it will be a lot easier to imagine when someone is in front of you, when you have already sparred and received some punches, because it will be easier to tell what kind of punches people can throw at you, right? For example, one of the most common combinations is 1, 2, 3, right? So how would you dodge that? You can either just parry, slip, roll, right? Parry, slip, roll. 1, 2, 3, right? Or another one is 1, 2, 5. 1, 2, 5, right? For that one, you would just, you know, you can either block, you can parry, you can block, you can slip, slip, step back, you know, shift your weight from here to here, and then block this right side of your body, right? So, right? Like this. Another thing you can really do is, if you have a hard time imagining things or like people in front of you, because I know some people don't have that visualization mind where they can imagine the person in front of them. What you can do is that you can get in front of the heavy bag or a ball bag or anything, any of these, right? And have them as your point reference, right? And imagine it's an opponent, right? That way you can move around. You can touch, and that way you can also measure your distance, you know? Actually, get comfortable understanding your distance of your punches and how far you are and how to get closer and so on. I hope this helped. If you enjoyed the video, let me know in the comments. If you have any questions, let me know and I will try my best to respond.